Good morning all. So in today's class we'll see the third case. So the third case is when your intermediate integral does not give you factors. So nammal aadhyam kanda case la there were two distinct factors for the quadratic equation r dy square minus s dx dy plus t dx square equal to 0. Rendu factors varuna distinct factors varuna case kandu. And perfect square right varuna rendu equal factors varuna case kandu, and we have seen how to find the solution using Monge's method in that two cases. Now in the third case we will see when you are not getting two factors of either a perfect square. Appo angana varuna problems il namukku endengilum common aayittulla endengilum terms cancel aavum dx or dy or allengi it can be p q anything, so something will cancel off and we will get in a simpler form. Appo aa equation ubayogicha intermediate integral kandupidikka, and then intermediate integral in you can find out the required solution. So that may be ordinary differential equations solve cheyinaale allengil lagrange's method or endengil method ubayogicha solution kandupidikka. So by the usual way of solving a PDE, you will get the solution. So we'll see a few examples. So the first question is to solve the equation q plus 1 s equal to p plus 1 t. So you'll get q plus 1 s minus p plus 1 t equal to 0. So you can see r is 0, s in the value q plus 1 varum, then t is minus of p plus 1 and v is equal to 0. So Monge's subsidiary equations, they are r dp dy plus t dq dx minus v dx dy equal to 0, then r dy square minus s dx dy plus t dx square equal to 0. So substitute r, s, t and v, so that will give us two equations. So minus of p plus 1 dq dx equal to 0 varum, then minus q plus 1 dx dy minus p plus 1 dx square equal to 0. So here you can see that you cannot reduce into two factors. Okay, so in the first equation, from the first equation, so if you divide by minus p plus 1 by dx, so we will get dq equal to 0. So we will simplify these two equations. Path equation in the dq equal to 0 item. So which gives q equal to c1. In the second equation, you can see that dx is common. So divide throughout by, okay, you can divide throughout by minus dx. For remaining, q plus 1 dy plus p plus 1 dx equal to 0. So that I can write as q dy plus dy, then p dx plus dx. Appo namukku dy dx terms varum, then p dx plus q dy. Ini p dx plus q dy nu parayna dz aanu, so that will give you dy dx and dz. So upon integrating we will get x plus y plus z equal to c2. So we have got q equal to c1 and x plus y plus z equal to c2. So x plus y plus z is equal to c2. So you can write q as a function of x plus y plus z. So that will give us the intermediate integral q equal to f of x plus y plus z. So if you integrate this equation, this is the first order PDE, so if you integrate it, you will get the required solution. So this is dou z by dou y equal to f of x plus y plus z. So when you integrate with respect to y, so the entire term that will be considered as function of y. Okay, so when you integrate you will get again a function of x plus y plus z, and when you integrate with respect to y, x will be considered as a constant. So they are in portion arbitrary function of x will come. So this is a constant. So therefore that will give us z equal to f of x plus y plus z plus g of x. So where f and g, they are arbitrary functions. So that is the required solution. அப்போ நம்ம செய்ததான நம்ம ஃபர்ஸ்டும் செகண்ட் இக்வேஷனும் சிம்பிளிஃபை செய்யா. அப்போ காமன் ஆயிட்ட எந்தெங்கிலும் டேர்ம்ஸ் கேன்சல் ஆகும். ஸோ சால்விங் தி ரிமைனிங் இக்வேஷன் ஆர் சால்விங் தி இக்வேஷன் யூ ஒப்டெயின் யூ வில் கெட் தி இன்டர்மீடியட் இன்டெக்ரல். அதினே அகைன் இன்டெகிரேட் செய்யா, யூ வில் கெட் தி சொல்யூஷன். ஸோ தி நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் சால்வ் பி க்யூ ஈக்குவல் டு எக்ஸ் இன்டூ பி எஸ் மைனஸ் கியூ ஆர். So first of all, let us write in the general form. So that is xqr minus xp s equal to minus pq. Appa r is s, xq, s is minus xp, t is 0 and v is minus pq. So this is the Monge subsidiary equation. And that r is t, v values substitute here. So you will get xq dp dy plus pq dx dy equal to 0 varum. Then the second equation is xq dy square plus xp dx dy equal to 0. Appa adhe equation la x dy kondu divide eya, sorry q dy kondu divide eya, and in the second equation x dy உண்டு divide here. So that is common in both equations. So from first equation you will get, when you divide by q dy you will get x dp plus p dx equal to 0. ரெண்டாமத்தை equation x dy வெச்சிட்டு divide here. So that will give us q dy plus p dx. For second equation is dz. P dx plus q dy in varayna dz varum. So dz is equal to 0. So you get z equal to c1. நீ அது போல e equation varayna d of xp ஆனு. But d of xp equal to 0 implies. So you will get xp equal to a constant. So that can be replaced by an arbitrary function of z. So now you have got the intermediate integral. The intermediate integral is solved here. So this is the first order. PD, so you can write the auxiliary equation, Lagrange's auxiliary equation, that is solving. So dx by x is equal to dy by 0 equal to dz by f of z. So you will get y equal to constant, and first term, third term kodi eduthu group cheya. So that will give the solution. Upon integrating, you will get log x equal to, so when you integrate dz by z, you will get an arbitrary function z plus c3. So c3 can be now replaced as a function of y. And adhuvala, okay. So that is the required solution. So that is log x equal to f of z plus g of y. So f and g, they will be arbitrary functions. So that is the solution. Now the third problem is solve z into qs minus pt equal to p q square. So it is in the standard form. R is 0 and s is zq and t is minus pz and v is p q square. The subsidiary equations are there. So the two subsidiary equations will be minus zp dq dx minus pq square dx dy equal to 0 and minus zq dx dy minus zp dx square equal to 0. In the first equation p dx common ana rendrathilum minus p dx common ana, so divide by minus p dx throughout. And in the second equation z dx which minus z dx which divide here. So we will get in the simplified form. So we will get z dq plus q square dy equal to 0 and q dy plus p dx equal to 0. P dx plus q dy equal to 0 and can be replaced by dz. So that is dz equal to 0. But z is equal to c1. we need to integrate the third equation. So, namukku cheyyanadana if you replace z by c1, the third equation will reduce in terms of q and y. But that will become in the form of a first order ordinary differential equation the form we will. Kaanam, namukku dq and dy maathrullu. So, you will get c1 dq plus q square dy equal to 0. So, you can write it as 1 by q square dq plus 1 by c1 dy equal to 0. So, on integrating, you will get 1 by q square dq in integrating by, you will get minus 1 by q plus this is y by c1 equal to c2. So, c1 replace here, c1 is z and c2 that's a constant. So, that will be an arbitrary function of z since z is equal to c1. So, we will get the solution as minus 1 by q plus y by z equal to f of z. So, that is the intermediate integral. You will have q in it. Q which is ordinary differential equation. Okay. So, the equation can be put in the form dou z by dou y equal to z by y minus z into f of z. Now, take the reciprocal. So, dou y by dou z will be equal to y by z minus f of z. Now, you can see that this is in the form of a linear differential equation. So, dou y by dou z minus y by z equal to minus f of z. So, this is linear in y and z. So, we will solve this as a linear equation. So, integrating factor under vidikya. Integrating factor is e raised to integral minus 1 by z dz. So, e raised to minus log z varum. So, that is equal to 1 by z. So, the solution is y into integrating factors y into 1 by z equal to integral of minus f of z by z dz equal dz plus constant. Now, since we are integrating with respect to y, so x will be considered as a constant. So, here, so when you integrate integral, that will be again a function of z. So, you can replace it by capital F of z. So, you will get y by z equal to f of z plus g of x. So, that implies y is equal to z f of z plus z into g of x. So, where f and g, they are arbitrary functions. So, that is the required solution of the PDE using Monge's method. Thank you.